In today's video, we'll be going over how to map a lens with your HU3. Preston's innovative lens mapping system translates the throw of any lens to one of 5 pre-printed focus marking rings. This means that you can learn a single ring to control all your lenses, or easily swap rings to optimize a particular shot. In this demo, we'll be using an MDR3, DM5 digital motor, and, of course, a hand unit 3. First, we'll set the correct file name for the lens. Press Menu and scroll down to Lens and press Enter. Select the lens manufacturer, press Enter. Next, select the lens type and press Enter. Finally, select New Lens. If you chose Other as your lens type, use the center button to toggle between prime or zoom lenses. Using the D-pad, enter the focal length for the lens and click Next. Enter the last 3 digits of the lens serial number using the D-pad. If desired, you can also press Add Note to add a unique note to the lens name. Now that the lens is properly labeled, we can begin the calibration process. With your lens highlighted in the lens menu, click Edit Lens and select Calibrate Focus. When entering focus marks, it's critical to view the lens from the same spot each time. Try to position yourself perpendicular to the witness mark. An inconsistent vantage point can cause inaccuracies of up to a line width, which will noticeably affect the mapping later on. Use the knob to rotate the lens until the witness mark of the lens lines up with the infinity mark. In some scenarios, you may notice that turning the lens to infinity is opposite the direction of infinity on the ring. If this is the case, the hand unit will prompt you to reverse the motor direction on the MDR. The motor should spin to the close focus end of the lens. Click Next. Realign infinity using the knob and click Next again. Now we begin entering the 10 calibration points. The HU3 prompts you to enter 2 feet as the first point, but make sure you scroll and select whichever point is the close focus or closest to the close focus on the lens. Align the mark on the lens with the witness mark, then click Next. Continue this process for 9 more points on the lens. It is critical that you only select points that are actual marks on the lens. Don't try to guess a point on the lens or the mapping will not work correctly. Instead, use the D-pad to scroll to a different choice in the menu if the one the HU3 prompts you for is not a mark on the lens. If you get to a calibration point and the options suggested by the hand unit don't match up with anything on the lens, simply go back a few points and select lower numbers, freeing up space for the later calibration points. After entering the final calibration point, click Next to return to the main menu. Press Ring, then use the D-pad to select which of the 5 pre-printed rings you plan to use. Here's a table showing the close focus of our 5 rings. Most users take advantage of lens mapping by using the same ring for all their lenses. However, in some scenarios, a different ring may be warranted to control the full range of the lens. In this example, we'll be using a C ring, which has a close focus of 2 feet, matching our lens. Click OK when your ring is selected. Depending on which ring you select, it's possible there will be an area of the knob where the motor doesn't move, such as when the close focus on the ring is lower than the close focus on the lens. This is normal. Now the lens has been mapped, the points on your labeled ring should match up to the marks on the lens, and you're ready to begin shooting. For more information, check out the HU3 manual on our website.